What I was dreaming of. So I with you guys because I thought it was pretty amazing to get some validation from my experiences as a child, which I just thought I was crazy. I moved into this apartment in Northern Virginia, and at first the apartment was normal. I was living there with my daughter Riot. She completely lives up to her age. It's very busy, especially in the presence of strangers. So at first everything was normal, and then again I'm dealing with another guy. This time he lived in the closet, and I'll tell you in a minute why. And he would hang out there in the middle of the night, just watching me. And then my dog started reacting to this guy, and she would just, you would just see her chasing somebody around the house, out the door. But it didn't really start getting serious until, again, I started dreaming about this guy. And the most memorable dream I had of him, I watched myself go outside of my body, and I was walking away from my bed, and I remember thinking to myself, man, so I go check out in the living room. I'm like, okay, I hear whispering. I turn the corner, and there's these three women in the center of my living room, just there, like, chanting. And I don't know what they were doing, but they were doing some kind of weird seance. And in my head, I'm like, okay, I'm really tired. I am not prepared to deal with this. I'm just going to go back to bed. So I start going back to the bedroom. And then that's when I notice this. And I'll never forget it, he's pacing back and forth in the bedroom, in the closet, and he's just muttering to himself. And it was very obvious to me that he was just not really stable. He was wearing like this long trench coat. I don't think he had any pants on because I just saw his legs. Something kept telling me, you know, don't let him notice you. Because if you let him notice you, something really bad's gonna happen. I don't know what that something is, but this is just what I'm hearing in my head. So I'm looking at him, I'm like, okay, I'm gonna take one step towards this. And all of a sudden, creak, my wooden floors creak, and I'm like, oh my God. And I look up, and I will never forget this guy's face. Oh my God. I watched, in that moment, we locked eyes, and I watched myself jump back into my body. And I just remember waking up like, oh my God, like, this is not good. The point in which I said to myself, okay, maybe it's about time I get into the paranormal, was my second major experience with him. I was taking a shower. All of a sudden, I start to hear these heavy, like, footsteps just coming into the bathroom. And I immediately freeze up. And I'm like, oh my God, you gotta be kidding me. And I think to myself, wait a second, is my dog okay? She's not reacting, she's not barking. Like, I swear to God, I locked the doors. How did anybody come into the apartment? And to make matters worse, as he's getting closer, he starts whistling this tune. So he's just like getting closer and closer and whistling. And I whistle for you, but I'm not very great at it. And all of a sudden, I'm like, okay, I know somewhere within me there are like dormant supernatural powers that are going to come out. I'm going to fight and I'm going to like kill this guy, whoever broke into my apartment. But none of that happened.